Students, the next chapter which we are going to start from Maths 2 is trigonometry. Now, students find this chapter little bit difficult. Already, we have seen the introduction of trigonometry in standard 9. In 10th standard, we are going to see some more topics related to it. Just go through my videos and I can assure you, you will find this chapter very easy. Now, in 9th standard, the first thing we learned about trigonometry is that the trigonometric ratios can be applied if and only if the given triangle is a right angle triangle. The first ratio which we saw was sine theta is equal to, what was the formula? Opposite upon hypotenuse. Cos theta is equal to adjacent upon hypotenuse. And tan theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent. Now, in 10th standard, we are going to see three more ratios, that is sin theta, reciprocal of sin theta, cosec theta. So what will be the formula? Hypotenuse upon opposite. Reciprocal of cos theta, sec theta. Hypotenuse upon adjacent. Reciprocal of tan theta, cot theta, adjacent upon opposite. So we can say that sin theta multiplied by cosec theta is always equal to 1. Cos theta multiplied by sec theta is equal to 1. Tan theta multiplied by cot theta is equal to 1. Now in 9th standard we saw one basic identity. The identity was sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Now we are going to see two more identities. 1 plus tan square theta is equal to sec square theta, and 1 plus cot square theta is equal to cosec square theta. Now let's see trigonometric table. Trigonometric table. Now, in trigonometric table, we consider standard angles 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree. Sin, cos, tan, cot, cosec, and sec. Now, let's see how to remember this trigonometric table. Now you have to just learn the values for sin. Sin 0 is 0. Sin 30 is half. Sin 45 is 1 upon root 2. Sin 60 root 3 upon 2. And sin 90 is 1. Now for cos, just change the position. So here it is 1. So here it will be 1. Here it is 0. So we will get here 0. Here it is root 3 upon 2. Root 3 upon 2. Half, half. 1 upon root 2 will be as it is. So what we did, first remember the values for sin. Once you know the value of sin, you can easily find out the value of cos. You have to just change the position. Now what is tan? Sin divided by cos. So 0 upon 1 is 0. 2, 2 will get cancelled. 1 upon root 3. 1 upon root 2 divided by 1 upon root 2, 1. Again 2, 2 cancel. Root 3 upon 1 is root 3. 1 upon 0 is not defined. Once you get the value of tan, same way find out the value of cot as we found out for cos. So here it will be not defined. Here it will be 0, root 3, 1 upon root 3, and 1 as it is. Now we have seen what is cosec. Cosec is reciprocal of sin. So 0, reciprocal of 0 will be 1 upon 0, not defined. Reciprocal of half, 2, 1 upon root 2, root 2. Root 3 upon 2, 2 upon root 3, and reciprocal of 1 will be 1. For sec, just change the position. 1 not defined, 2 upon root 3, 2, and root 2 as it is. Now let's see one sum. In this sum, they have given us the value of sin and we have to find out the value of cos. So given sin theta is equal to 20 upon 29. Cos theta is equal to question mark. We know. Now, we have seen one identity including sine and cos. What is the identity? Sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Now, we know the value of sine 20 upon 29 bracket square plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, what is the square of 20? 400. Square of 29? 841 plus cos square theta is equal to 1. Therefore, cos square theta is equal to 1 minus 400 upon 841. Therefore, cos square theta is equal to cross multiply 841 minus 400 upon 841. Therefore, cos square theta is equal to 441 upon 841. Therefore, cos theta is equal to square root of 441 upon 841. Therefore, I can say cos theta is equal to 21 upon 29. So, we can say that students should remember, if you know the value of sine, we can find out the value of cos. If you know the value of cos, we can find out the value of sine by just applying the identity sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1.